To watch more videos and support our channel, Dalit Poetry and Literature, please subscribe.
Radhabhai Kambale. You could not have found a single person living in the Sita Bardi Anand Nagar colony, formerly Maharpura, in Nagpur, who did not know Radhabhai. That was because of her capacity to work and organize activist. Radhabhai Kambale was a fearless and steering activist, with a penetrating intelligence. Herself a mill worker, she was at the forefront in organizing meetings, satyagrahas, conferences, and demonstrations on mill workers' issues. In 1929, the British government sent a labor commission to India to carry out a survey of the situation of industrial workers. The commission recorded testimonies of several political leaders in Bombay and Nagpur who were connected with the workers. On that occasion, among representatives of the mill and the BD workers from Nagpur region like Babu Hardas LN, Rao Saheb Thavre and Kalicharan Nandagavli. The testimony of Radhabhai Kambale was also put on record. This shows that Radhabhai was active in the workers' movement from an early date. She was on the executive committee of the Nagpur Mill Workers Union established under the leadership of Ruikar. However, after a branch of Independent Labour Party was set up with Rao Saheb Phule as a chairman, she worked for that organization under Baba Saheb's dynamic leadership. She was the first woman labor leader in Vidarbha to make fiery speeches to audience, numbering thousands. Radhabhai worked day and night to ensure the success of the 1942 conference of the Scheduled Caste Federation. She was the deputy chairperson of the Women's Welcome Committee for that conference and later attended all meetings and gatherings of the Federation with other leaders, making speeches and doing propaganda. In 1946, there were general elections. To prevent the untouchable candidate Sakharam Meshram from being elected by the Dalit mill workers who were in majority, Ruikar, the Rashtriya Mill Workers Union candidate, purposely instigated a strike. His game was that the Dalit workers should not leave because of the strike and allow their candidate to be elected. To defeat this strategy, the Scheduled Caste Federation resolved to break the strike. The Dalit laborers began to go back to work. The caste Hindu workers attacked them, and the Dalit workers resisted collectively. Women workers were also attacked. At this point, Radhabhai Kambale assumed leadership and led the Dalit women workers back to work. She advised them to tuck a packet of chili powder into the waist of their saris to defend themselves and to deter the attackers. An account of this strike appeared in the Janta Weekly of 22nd February 1946. This news item throws light on the attacks on the untouchable workers by caste Hindus and bring out Radhabhai's role. It reads as follows: when the untouchable people were going to work in groups on the morning of the 18th, Hindu hoodlums attacked them and threw stones on them. The hooligans beat up Lakshman Narayane, municipality member, and his wife in the Itwara area. When Nababai Kambale was going to work with a group of 10 to 15 women, they too were beaten up and subjected to abusive and filthy language. The police looked on passively, but Radhabhai was not deterred and took all the women to the mill work. Radhabhai Kambale was known for her speeches. While fighting against injustice, she would spare no one and express her views in a forthright manner. During the primary elections held in Bombay on 3rd January 1946, Sokhaji Gangurde was brutally murdered by Congress Party hoodlums. A huge rally was held at Kasturchand Park in Nagpur on 15 January 1946 under the chairmanship of Rao Saheb Thavre to condemn the murder. About 20,000 persons were present. On this occasion, Radhabhai Kambale spoke forcefully against the non-violent hooliganism of Gandhi and lathi charge by the police. Radhabhai Kambale also campaigned for elections on behalf of the Scheduled Caste Federation. Voting was to be held at the Bhide Girls School. On the day of the election, Radhabhai Kambale was prevented from casting her vote. However, soon after, Anusaya Bai Kale, a woman candidate from the Congress Party, was allowed to enter. When Radhabhai saw Anusaya Bai drive up in her car and go in to vote, she was furious. She walked straight in, caught Anusaya Bai by the arm and dragged her out. Radhabhai received many invitations to give speeches because of her fearlessness and staunch convictions. She had no schooling beyond the third standard, but her speeches were inspiring and thought-provoking. On 25th September 1946, a meeting was held in the evening in Satyagraha camp at Babulkheda under the chairmanship of Raj Bhuj. Radhabhai Kambhale made a most inspiring speech on the occasion. During the Satyagraha, Radhabhai would address the people every morning and evening along with other leaders. Also, she took care of the women taking part in the Satyagraha. She made all the arrangements for the women who had come from far-off villages for the Satyagraha. In 1949, there was a large-scale retrenchment of mill workers and the workers were faced with starvation. It was apparent that if the retrenchment continued, several families would be uprooted and their lives would be shattered. A demonstration of 100 women mill workers went to the secretariat in Nagpur to protest against the layoff of the workers and to try and prevent further layoffs. Radhabhai Kambhale led the march. The labor secretary, Mr. Bernard, gave the women a patient hearing and assured them that the problems of the mill workers would be looked into. The retrenchment too were stopped immediately. Thus, it can truthfully be stated that this indomitable activist Radhabhai Kambhale was the first woman leader of the mill workers. Radhabhai died in 1970.